days. Na-na-na-na, oh my better days. Na-na-na-na, oh my better days.
Every time I pray for better days, every day feel it coming on the way. Gotta step on every pace and no matter what it takes. Tapos sing mereka bilang ini itu.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is your girl Nubian Princess. So I really am under the weather today. I actually woke up this morning and I could not get out of the bed. I was so weak. My body was aching. I was so tired. But I'm feeling better. And I wanted to upload kind of like an update to my lock extensions. So I got my lock extensions done on June 10th. And so this video is probably, it was probably taken on June 13 or 14. I basically had to go to Atlanta to get my hair done. And when I came back from Atlanta, I had it in an updo. And the updo was cute and all. Here's a picture of the updo before I started taking it out. So the top part was actually in a bun, the one that's hanging. So I just took that bun out, and right now it's just kind of hanging. And this is the oil that she gave me to oil my scalp. So I was going to leave it in an updo, but the updo was a bit too tight, and it was causing me to have a headache. And I have neck issues. I had surgery on my neck. And so any type of tension on my head, like if I wear a wig that's too tight or a hairstyle that's too tight, the kind of pain that I endure is a lot more than a normal person would. So I decided to do what was best for my neck as far as my health situation. And so I decided to take the updo down. And so I've taken the updo hairstyle down, and I'm just kind of playing around with the back of the hair to see what I could possibly do. The hair is only about 6 inches. And the reason why I started it off at 6 inches is because I did not want to get really long lock extensions. I just wanted something that I don't have to really go through that ugly, ugly phase that people call it. I didn't want my hair to be like baby short. I wanted just the right amount of hair to where I could, you know, just put it up in like a cute little ponytail. So I'm trying to basically twist some of it in the back so that way the twists don't unravel or the dreads don't unravel. I like the parts. The parts are big enough. And you can see my edges. They did grow, but obviously I'm still struggling. And so, yeah, so I just wanted to come on here and record a video showing you guys what the locks look like after I took them down from the updo. Now, when she was telling me about my scalp is going to be itchy, I thought that she was, you know, I was like, oh no, I don't get dandruff, I'll be okay. So because your scalp is exposed, you guys, your scalp gets really itchy. When I took this updo down, it felt so good to get in the middle of my scalp, that middle part of my head, and just rub it. It felt so good. And then I used the oil that she gave me and I put it in there. But when she said itchy scalp, I now know what she means. Now with lock extensions, I don't know if it's because of the hair being afro kinky, it will make your scalp itchy. So get ready for that, okay? It doesn't mean that you have something wrong with you. It doesn't mean that something's wrong with the hair. It's just your scalp is not used to being exposed. Mine is because I have braids, or I've had braids. But somebody that might have like a sew-in or something else or a wig does not necessarily have their scalp exposed. So when you finally have your scalp exposed, you're going to experience a lot of itching, okay? So just be patient with the process. And yeah. And then another thing that I found was the twist that I had, the two-strand twist that I had. The rubber band, I'm glad that I took it out early because the rubber band would have made like a dent in my lock. And I don't want anything that's going to damage my lock. I really just want my locks to be even. I plan on doing my own retwist. I plan on doing my own fixing. If I have any type of lock that is loose or, you know, not, you know, the way it's supposed to be, I have the tool. I ordered the tool from Amazon and I'm going to make sure I basically keep up with my locks. So, sorry guys. So I'm taking the hair down and right now I have the top and I have the bottom. I'm still trying to take this two-strand twist out. The two-strand twist, you guys, literally, that was the longest part. It took me forever to take those two-strand twists out. The rubber band was so tight on there. So I just wanted to come on here and give you guys an update. Basically let you know that even though the updo was cute and everything, I had to take it out. So right now what I... The hairstyle that I have it in, I don't think you're going to be able to see it in this video, but I have it all, like all of it up in a ponytail, and then I have like a front bang thing with some of it going to the right. That's it. So you see how you have the hair on the top that is just kind of like, you know, sticking up? Yeah, I have it in an updo, and then I have a front bang going to the right. Like, I really just don't care. I like the whole messy look. So it is what it is. If somebody is going to judge me because I have dreadlocks, that is their business. The one thing I will say is that I will make sure that my dreadlocks don't stink and I'll make sure that I keep them washed. So I just wanted to come on here and give you guys an update. So yeah. So if you're going to get a lock, if you're going to get lock extensions and at the end of it, they want to do like some type of updo, make sure that it's not too tight. She did ask me, was it too tight? And I kept saying no, but I should have said yes because my neck, you know, that surgery that I had on my neck causes everything to be extra painful. So lesson learned, but I took it down. It is what it is. So I've been trying to watch videos to try to see if I can get ideas on hairstyle. But right now, we're just going to do the all up in a ponytail and the front bang to the right. That's it. And so, I just wanted to come on here and tell you guys what was going on. And thank you guys so much for watching my channel. I saw that I have a couple of new subscribers. I really appreciate you guys. Make sure you stay tuned to watch my journey. I'm definitely going to come on here and update you guys on my lock journey. I cannot wait to see what my progress is going to be in 6 months. I can't wait to see what my progress is going to be in a year. And I'm literally going to stick this out. I'm not going to give up. I have always wanted dreadlocks and I finally got them. So, right now what I'm doing is just laying my edges down. As you guys can see, I have edges. It's just, you know, they're not full or, you know, thick, but I have edges. My hair grows all the way to my eyebrows. So, I have a weird hairline. I got it from my daddy. All right, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Ooh, English. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for more updates. Please make sure you click the subscribe button and the notification bell so that way you know when I upload a video. All right. Take care. Bye-bye.